Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over how you can use a blank button and custom backgrounds to create incredible navigation inside your Power BI reports. Let's head on over to it. Wait, before we go over to that, remember to like, subscribe, and maybe even turn that alarm bell. Really helps the channel. Really appreciate it. More on a competition I got going at the end of the video, so stay tuned. Okay, so in Power BI, you've got lots of content, and you want to give a real good way to allow your users to navigate that through that content and create a good experience is by creating some great Power BI some backgrounds that allow you to easily navigate through that in a consistent, reliable format. Now, I did a presentation on how you can use backgrounds in data storytelling a few months ago. I want to run through some of the details around how I actually did this so you can see how easy it is for you to create these types of backgrounds and this type of incredible content. So links below to where you can go download this stuff, but I work a lot inside of PowerPoint. Big shout out to Chris Hamill for showing me how to do this stuff. He's the one I think pioneered this method, but it's really easy. Basically, this is just PowerPoint, right? Like, everything is exactly the same as you would inside of any old PowerPoint. Is you just go in and let me see here. You go in and you build out your slide the way you'd want. You lay out, you know, your page where you want to have your key metrics, your title, some visuals, and maybe even some details. And then you kind of run through and you create these for each of the, you know, however many pages or navigations that you're going to have inside your report. Now, in this case, I chose the Avengers because I wanted to highlight that, you know, in some cases, it may make sense to have a consistent color theme across your entire reports. Other times, you may want to use the color theme to change up based upon what it is users are looking at to give them visual cues that they've switched the story around, right? So that's just a little tip for better storytelling, right? So I basically created these pages out here, right? Then very easily just, you know, went to, you know, full-on presentation mode. Did my little like screen capture dealio thing here, right? You can't see that because that's not visible. But then I saved these off into files, so that becomes really easy for me to go and grab these guys as I'm building out my Power BI report. So when I go into open up a brand new Power BI report, and I've got the finished product is over here, and I'll you know, that's available in the download link as well. But when I go into Power BI, if I want to create this custom navigation, I just simply go over to my my formatting paintbrush here. I click on page background. I choose on add an image. I plunk in that where I pasted those images, and I start to set these guys into the background. Click on open. It adds it in. I go to my transparency, set it down to 0. And then I go on, change it over to fit. I've got my navigation. I continue to iterate through this, choosing my different backgrounds, changing my different navigations in place. So I've got 2 in, and you need at least 2 to be able to show you this little trick. So I'm not going to go any further on this one, but I'm going to change the name of this. So it's a little easier for me to understand when I'm navigating back and forth between my pages. And, all right, and now here's the trick of, here's the trick when it comes to using that that blank button. What I just do is I go up here to my insert on buttons, and I go down and I select a blank button, okay? I can now go up and I can set this guy up at the start. I can go over here and I can do a couple things inside the settings. Let's see if I can hone in on this. I'm going to turn off my outline, I'm going to turn off my background, and I'm going to turn off my visual header, and I'm going to choose to turn my action on. Okay. Whoops. Here. I'll get out of that. But I'm going to check icon off, outline off, background off, visual header off, basically turn them all off, and then change my action to on. And this is going to be a page navigation. Now, in this case, this is going to go nowhere because, well, it would be the one I'd want to return to my home screen. But if I copy this one, when I have this selected guy, control copy, go over to Iron Man, and I paste it over it, I can now change my action over to change it over to Avengers. Now I've got a button I can test out. When I click on control click, it sends me over to the last page. Now all I have to do is repeat that for Iron Man. Now the nice thing about this is to leave this with the nice thing about this blank space is that with the background and border turned on, you can ensure that you're fully covering the visual or your navigation. So users can't just be clicking on blank stuff and not going where they want to go. But I change all these items. I notice I'm a little overlapped here, so I don't want to do that. Change that. Change my action to page navigation. Set it to Iron Man. And I always like to copy it and paste that onto the next page just for consistency's sake, right? Especially once I get this page built out with all my other pages in place, then it becomes super easy to ensure that I have the same buttons in everywhere. But now I can test this by control clicking. I pop over to Iron Man, control click, and I go back to the Avengers page. Now I can repeat this for Captain America. Right, set that background, add an image, choose my Captain America image, okay, choose fit, turn it down to zero, this guy's good. Now I can paste in my Iron Man button. I can copy and paste in my Avengers button. And now I can go back through and I can put in my Captain America button on each of those, the previous spaces, pages. So again, this makes this fairly easy. This blank button is like the magic button that you'll end up using all the time. Frankly, the other ones are nice, but holy cow, this makes it super, super easy to just use and replicate all over the place. Again, copying and pasting it as I go, so that I have my navigation to Iron Man, navigation to Cap, right? And I can test all these out and everything's up and running. So as you can see, super easy to add in and create an incredible report experience for users just using this blank button. All right. I hope you found that very useful when it comes to building out your report stuff. This blank button is a super champion. Really appreciate it. If you would take the time to hit like, subscribe down below. And this is a limited time thing we got going on right now. If you've hit like, you've hit subscribe, you turn and you leave a comment on one of the videos, when I hit 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to be giving away not one, not two, but I'm going to give away 3 Data God t-shirts. So please like and subscribe, leave a comment. Really helps with the logarithm on the back end and stuff. And you too could own one of your, that's the Chris Finland, the paginated bear Data God. You too could earn or win your choice of a Data God t-shirt. As always, if you like this content, you want to buy me a coffee, COVID doesn't allow that, but head over to carosbi.com, hit buy me a coffee. I'll ship you out a thank you letter, and I'll toss in some of these free I Love Power BI stickers out there. This is my personal favorite I Love Power BI one, but I do have the magic holographic one, and I've got the classic I Love Power BI. I got some other stickers and stuff. I'll just throw those in, as my way of saying thank you. Thank you, guys. You've been great. Peace.